What's going on, everybody? And in today's GTA 5 video, I'm going to be going over and reviewing the new Ocelot Pariah, which was a part of the Doomsday Heist DLC. And I'm not really sure what this vehicle is based off of. It's an Ocelot vehicle, so that means it's Jaguar in real life. But I can't really figure out what exactly it's based off of. But it's a pretty good looking car, especially in the front. I'm not really a big fan of the way the back looks, but the front, the sides, I mean, everything else on it looks good. Not to mention, it's now the best car in GTA Online in the sports class. So let's check out the customization on this baby. We have race brakes, bumpers. Bumpers, you have a lot of bumper options, but I'm not really a fan of a lot of them. I like the GT bumper. I like the one that I just had on there. The GT bumper looked good. I think I'm going to use that one. Then you got three diffuser options. I'm just going to put the most expensive one on there for now. Engine, explosives, blah, blah, blah. You got hood options, but I don't really like many of the hood options. A lot of them are a little bit extra, in my opinion. GT hood, no, I don't like that. I think I like the single scoop hood. Yeah, I like that one. That one looks good to me. Lights, xenon lights, livery. Now there's a lot of livery options. Most of them are like racing skirt stripes. They're just different colors and different variations. Like you see those up off to the side. I'm not gonna put any stripes on those there though. I think that's a little bit tacky in my opinion. I just like my cars more simple. Yellow and black license plate. Now I'm not really sure what color would look good on this car. I'm thinking more of like baby blue, like ultra blue or racing blue. With some black rims, I think would look good, but I'm not really sure. I'm just going to put a racing blue on here for now. Let's see, secondary, maybe white, I could see. I mean, I can always go back and change it later, so I'm just going to put that on there for now and see if I like it or not. The secondary roof's a little bit too much. I think I'm just going to leave the roof stock. Yeah, I think I'm going to leave the roof stock. Okay, so skirts. Now, the Pariah skirt is really cool. I think that adds a really nice detail to the car. It adds the name of the car on the side, which I think makes it look pretty cool. You got a lot of spoiler options. Most of them are really big spoilers, which I'm not a fan of. So I'm just going to go with the simple one right here. Lower the suspension, transmission, turbo tuning, and wheel type. I'm just going to slap a pair of rims on here just because this part of the video is meant to show you guys the customization. So I'm just going to put some black Super G's on here. And I think we're good to go. Is there anything else we missed? No, I didn't mean to do that. Crap. I don't like the custom tires. Windows, I'll just tint them out just to make it look cool. But yeah, I think that's it. This vehicle has a decent amount of customization. I think it makes it look a lot better, especially the front bumper. That front GT bumper, I think, makes a big difference. I kind of wish I didn't put the white as the secondary color on here. I think it would look a lot better with black, but this car is fast. Like, when I'm driving this car in free mode right now, I mean, it accelerates. And when you get up to the top speed of this vehicle, according to Bruffy1322, who is like a big car tester in GTA, said that this vehicle has a better top speed than any supercar or any car in the whole game, even though it's only a sports car. But I think that might mean that there's a nerf coming for this car soon, because it is completely overpowered in the sports class, and it's better than a lot of the supercars. So I think it was put in the wrong class, or they didn't mean to make it as overpowered as they did. But while it is the way it is, I think you should definitely go out and buy this vehicle, because it absolutely dominates. And I'm not really a fan of the way the back looks on this car, but the front does look amazing, and it handles well. It has very good acceleration, and along with that, it can get obliterated too. Did you know that? I mean, that's a pretty cool fact about it. It can get hit by the orbital cannon. So anyways, like I said, I'm not really sure what this car is based off of, but it's a pretty good car in the end. And if you have the money, I mean, it's not too pricey, but I think you should go buy it if you can afford it, because it will win you a lot of races in the sports car class. And if you're really big into racing in GTA Online, it might even win your money back. So that's about it for this video. The Ocelot Pariah is a great new addition to the game, and I highly encourage you go buy it. With all that said, I'll see you guys in the next video.